It's Madden NFL 24 on EA Sports, where we'll see teams who have been division rivals since 1961. It's the Green Bay Packers and the Minnesota Vikings on Sunday night.
Nightfall in Minneapolis in December usually spells freezing temps, and that is precisely the case outside these walls, but we are a comfortable 72 degrees inside U.S. Bank Stadium.
Tonight, we've got a great Sunday night matchup on tap, as it'll be the Green Bay Packers taking on the Minnesota Vikings. Brandon Gordon, so pleased to be joined, as always, by Charles Davis. CD, these Vikings had things rolling in 2022, a 13-4 record, new head coach, an exciting offense, but it all came crashing down in another early playoff exit.
And that really was because of the defensive side of the ball. They had a terrific record. Would they win 11 games by one score or less, an NFL record? Got to get strong on the defensive side in order to get deeper into the playoffs.
And meanwhile, for the visiting Packers, one era ends, another begins. This is a team that finished 8-9 last year, missed out on the playoffs at the very end. What needs to happen for the green and gold to be playoff bound once more?
Everyone's focusing on how they're starting over on the offensive side of the ball. But to me, they have an accumulation of talent on defense that needs to play like a top 10, top 5 defense in the NFL.
Anders Carlson has his teed up, ready to get started.
And we are underway from downtown Minneapolis.
And a nice return sets him up pretty good here right at the 30-yard line.
So here's the Viking offense making their way out.
They're led out by the rookie, picked 164th in this past draft out of BYU, Jaren Hall.
We're seeing it more and more in this league, how teams love to have athletes back there taking the snaps, guys who can throw it and move around and get yards with their legs if needed. He's one of the best examples that we see out there right now. He can throw for hundreds of yards one week and then run for 100-plus the next. He adds an extra dimension that really confounds defenses when he puts it all together.
Now it's Hall.
That's complete to Justin Jefferson. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. 23 yards on the play. And we see the emphasis early here. Get your star receiver involved, able to do it successfully.
Not a bad start to begin with, that's for sure. And to me, this play says, our guy is better than your guy's. Because, you know, a player of his stature, he won't just be single covered all game long. It's going to involve multiple people. And right away, they told the other team, guess what? He's just better.
He's been a one-man wrecking crew these last couple of plays. This time, 18 more and a first down.
That early game script that they drew up is working pretty well here on this first drive. Already in field goal range, Charles, knocking on the door of the red zone.
You know, Brandon, when we met with the coaching staff, they kind of predicted that they would come out firing like this. I think you and I were a little skeptical it would be this easy, but they certainly knew what they were doing in scouting, in preparation, and understanding what their team was capable of.
Another big gainer that time. This one goes for 19 yards.
That's a very nice game there. A confidence-building run. Love the execution up front. And the way he pressed the hole, absolutely perfect.
Now a first and 10 at the 11.
Going to run with Madison again. And he's going to be brought down just shy of the 5 at the 6.
They've created a nice sustained drive off of plays like that. A nice strong run there that keeps them advancing the ball.
Now second and 5. Snap will come from the 6.
They'll go Madison up the middle. And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. No gain on the play there, so they're left with a 3rd down and 6.
I think what we just saw there, partner, was linebacking speed that can trump O-line power. We see that at times because he filled the gap before the offensive lineman could get to the next level and take him on.
Here's Hall.
And he'll be touched down here, but not before he does pick up the first. Able to get what they need to keep the drive going with a 6-yard pickup on 3rd down. Great mix of play calling so far. Three runs, three passes. All three passes have been completions. First and goal.
I think on defense now, you have to almost take a chance. Rely on your scouting. Pick a play you think they would run here and just load up.
And he'll get in. Touchdown, Minnesota. Alexander Mattison. A touchdown run there from a yard out. And the Vikings put the Knights' first points on the board as they take the early lead. And that caps off what was really a balanced opening drive for them, Charles. They work in the rushing game and the aerial attack, and they end it with a touchdown.
Strong in so many ways, wasn't it, partner? Their ability to throw it and run it and accomplish their goal, they've got to like the way that they started this ball game.
Now Joseph tees it up to kick off following the touchdown. Nixon elects not to return it, and this comes out to the 25. So here are the new-look Packers set to go to work. And at the helm here in 2023, a lot of eyes on this man in his fourth NFL season, Jordan Love.
And at the start of Jordan Love's NFL career, he had one of the best seats in the stadium watching Aaron Rodgers work. But now he's looking for more than that. Rocket arm, big play potential. And he wants to show this organization that he's capable of being a dependable starter for the foreseeable future.
Love and the Packers now with a first and 10 at their own 25-yard line. To throw now, here's Love. And that one going to be off target and incomplete. Charles, already trailing by a touchdown early. This offense, how imperative is it for them to get points out of this drive?
Well, they feel like they have to go ahead and match because of what was already on the board against their defense. But I think even more so, you just want to avoid three and outs. You want to be able to stay on the field for a little while, let your defense catch their breath a little bit, even if you don't score any points.
Another throw on second down, and this one incomplete as well.
This defense has passed its first two tests by forcing back-to-back incompletions. They know there's probably another throw coming on third down. Let's see if they decide to force the issue by sending people on a blitz.
So back-to-back incompletions, and that has them staring at a third and 10. Love now. Complete and past the 40 before he's out of bounds. Give him 18 on that play, and Green Bay has the first as well.
I know at the end of games, coaches always tell us that no one play won or lost a game. This seems pretty important early, doesn't it? Their ability to pick up that first down on third down, I thought that was key.
Well, you're already in the hole after the touchdown on the other side. How will you respond? We talk about that a lot, and they responded pretty well there. You go three and out, I think you give up a lot of momentum. You get down two scores, could be an entirely different game.
So they've got a nice drive going now. They're in good shape. What's interesting to me is they're also in that spot of the field where you would take a shot. Do you change that up just because you're down a touchdown?
This is second and 8. Working out of the gun. Love. He has it complete to Christian Watson. With a quick slant, good for 8 and a first. Love. That's complete to Wicks. Second down and 8. Out of the shotgun, it's Love. Pass caught, it's Romeo Doubs. And brought down, but able to get it to their 30-yard line. A good-looking drive for the Packers so far. It's a first down.
We got to like what you're seeing from this offense here on the first drive. A nice, sustained series to begin the game, and it will continue after picking up another first there.
Would you say the word methodical comes to mind? I love the execution. I love what they're doing on this drive. They're controlling the ball, controlling the game, controlling the clock.
Now left side, a completion to his tight end.
Short completion, just 4 yards, and that will bring up second down. And forget about the run to set up the pass. They're just coming out throwing.
Forget trying to set anything up. They feel like they have the advantage. They feel like they have the matchups, and they're just attacking right now.
Yep, going to the air on the opening drive.
They will throw again here with Jordan Love. Throw right side, hauled in by Dobbs. And this is going to turn into another first down as the tackle is made at the Viking 16. Here's Love. Looking end zone, but it's incomplete.
Everyone see this offense try and spread the field a little bit and utilize the outside third of the field, especially against man coverage. But that time, the defense was up to the task, forcing the incompletion.
And this should be the final play before the quarter ends.
To the air again, Love. He'll find a goal complete.
And he's going to be brought down on what will be the final play of this first quarter.
After 1-7-0 on EA Sports. The Packers with the football here to begin the second quarter as they've got it with a third down coming up.
Sometimes the game is pretty simple. Put a few extra defensive backs on the field, give them nowhere to throw the football, force the incompletion, and get off the field on third down.
So off goes Love. On is Carlson for the Packer field goal.
From the left hash, a chip shot here. And this one is right through. And they are on the board, but still trailing. It's 7-3.
So both teams come away with points on their opening drives. Now they still trail. They answered the touchdown with a field goal, but at least able to break that goose egg here early.
And that is what's important, right? Because they didn't let that initial touchdown go unanswered. Took the ball themselves, moved it downfield, and put it through the post for 3 points. Game on.
So after the made field goal, here's Carlson to send it away. Kenny Nwangu now out of his end zone. And he will make it back to the 15, and that's it. Good coverage there by the kick team.
The Vikings taking the field here for their second drive of the game.
This drive here beginning probably with a pair of motivated groups. Remember, the offense scored a touchdown on their last time out, looking to repeat that in Charles's defense. They were very frustrated after giving up 6 the last time on the field.
And frankly, it's just a battle of wills in a lot of ways, because you know they're both motivated. They both game plan for this drive, and they both have specific outcomes in mind. To me, it just comes down to who can execute better and which side can step up and assert its will over the other.
They will get 4 yards here on the first down run, and that'll make it 2nd and 6.
Well, on every play call, you realize it's not going to go for a touchdown, so a lot of your calls are setting things up for maybe later in the game, trying to establish the inside run, run with toughness now, hopefully get to the perimeter later, and let's face it, you could do worse than a 4-yard run on first down.
Throwing here is Hall.
Throwing over the middle, and it's incomplete.
Those are the ones you dream of as defenders. I think if he gets eyes on the ball a little bit earlier, he might come away with it. Instead, it's going to wind up as just an incomplete pass.
So after the second down incompletion, they'll come up now against a 3rd and 6. Here's Hall. He's got his target. That's complete. And he will have a Vikings first down as they're able to get the 3rd down conversion.
We always hear about the connections some quarterbacks have with certain receivers. I think this guy has a connection with just about everyone. Didn't mind throwing it in there against double coverage to him.
Shows some confidence, supreme confidence.
Big time confidence that he would make the play for him, and he did.
Here's Madison running on 1st down. And oh, he sheds a tackle. Now he's got some space. And they're able to get this one across the 35. 40 yards rushing for him now on just 6 carries to this point. What makes a draw play like that successful?
Well, we did see where he made the first wave miss, and that was a big part of it. But a lot of it is just being actors back there, making the defense think it's going to be a pass.
Hall to throw it. Well, a quick throw there, but it's going to be incomplete.
This could be the start of a nice stand from this defense now after getting walked backwards on this drive. Come through with another one here, and you have them staring at a 3rd and long, and that puts the defense in a position to dictate to the offense.
Now a 2nd and 10. Hall. Out route to Jefferson, and he's got it. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. Over 70 yards receiving now for him in this first half alone, as he's got a 1st down on that last catch. Here's Madison running left, and they're going to stop him right at the line of scrimmage. Just no cutback lane to be found whatsoever. 2nd and 10. Looked like he was trying to bounce it outside, but no success.
Yeah, sometimes you got to just figure out where you're going to go, and sometimes you just have to take it to another spot. In trying to get it outside, the defensive pursuit was there and just ran him down.
Back to throw, Hall. Complete. And they're going to be set up down around the 15-yard line. That goes for a gain of 31.
There's the arm strength that we saw in college and during the scouting process. And really, it's not just the arm strength there, but the placement as well. To me, that was an excellent combination of arm talent and accuracy.
So after the big play, look at this, all the way down at the 15 now on 1st and 10. And they'll send the slot in motion left. Here's a fake on the jet sweep, and instead a give up the middle. And that play going absolutely nowhere as he's belted before he could get out of the backfield.
I thought he did a nice job there setting an edge and making sure nothing could get to the outside. But he decided that wasn't enough for him. Worked his way back inside and made the tackle on the ball carrier.
That loss of 3, a rare stumble on a promising drive. Here's 2nd and 13. Gets around him, and they'll bring him down at the 13-yard line. It'll be a gain of 5, and it's going to bring up a 3rd and about 7 left.
But you got to give kudos to your offensive line and the guy carrying the ball, because they were in a 2nd and long situation. It seemed pretty dire, but they brought it back to 3rd and manageable with that run.
Now 3rd down and 7. Now Hall. And he'll go down. Brought down at the 20-yard line. Preston Smith comes in for the sack. 2 minutes to play in this first half. 7-3, our score. Now Greg Joseph for the field goal try. From the left hash, this from 37. The kick by Joseph is good. And they push the lead up to a touchdown now at 10-3. So a nice kick there as they are able to add on to their lead.
And that's exactly what you're looking to do. Maneuver yourself into range. That way, if your drive stalls out, you're able to get something out of it. And they do so right there.
Joseph now to kick this one away. This fielded right at the goal line. And no chance to get away as they'll get him down at about the 17-yard line. The Packers offense here coming back out for their second drive. And last time they got 3 points, but it was a chip shot field goal. And when you go to the sideline after a chip shot field goal, maybe the offense not too happy.
It's a balancing act, isn't it? Because you're exactly right. They're none too pleased that they didn't punch it in for 6 points. But they also have to remember they did put points on the board.
3 points is 3 points.
And in this league, you take points when you can get them. Not easily done.
First down, going to the air with Love. Drops it to Jones in the flat. And he'll be a couple yards shy of the 20 at the 18. Call it a gain of a yard, and it'll be second down.
That's a good job there by the corner. We do talk about this a lot, that a lot of corners see their job as simply covering receivers. Tackling isn't everyone's thing. But in this case, he came up quickly and made a nice, sure tackle.
To pass, here's Jordan Love. And his throw is incomplete. That pass just a little bit off. It looked like maybe he tried to force it in there.
Game speed, always different, no matter what you do in practice. Can't simulate it, right? So your decision-making, everything has to be a little bit quicker. Sometimes it can throw you off until you adjust.
After an incomplete pass on second down, that'll leave him trying to convert on 3rd and 9. Now, meanwhile, a pass that should have been intercepted. Falling incomplete.
This defense has certainly played well so far in this game, and the coverage has been tight on just about every throw. Forced a few here so far in this game, and now it brings up 4th down.
On 4th down, the Packers call on Daniel Whelan to punt. Brandon Powell deep from Minnesota. Let's take it inside his own 40. That'll go as a 39-yard punt. Give him 9 on the return. And the Vikings will take over here, 1st and 10. Alexander Mattison leading this Vikings offense out there to begin the next drive. He's over 40 yards here in the second quarter. Been nice and effective for them, hasn't he?
He has definitely been dependable and really shouldn't underestimate what he's getting done here, because anytime you're on a pace that's going to approach 100 yards, you've really done some damage in an NFL game.
And now he's looking just to add to his totals. Now it's Hall. Throwing middle, but it's incomplete. That is the first time that they've targeted him that he has not come down with a catch.
He's caught everything that's been thrown his way. A dominant pass receiver that can break down any defense, because when he's doing that kind of work, it really hurts you on the back end.
And even though it's an incompletion there, I think they're going back to that well. Here's Hall. And that falls to the ground, incomplete. A nice job of bodying him up defensively, and now it brings up 3rd down.
He was trying to get that one out to his running back out of the backfield, but that one was read and timed perfectly, and they were able to break it up.
Now they face a 3rd and 10 after back-to-back incompletions. Back to throw. Ball. And this is going to be caught, but they'll say out of bounds. So it's incomplete. I don't know, he had to be pretty quick with his fingers to start and stop after the ball hit the ground. I'm giving him some credit.
Well, I'm thinking about the mental focus, you know?
Yeah.
Or the mental focus.
Yeah,
the
that's
thing.
True.
Got to stay with it.
That's true. So on 4th down, Ryan Wright on to punt for Minnesota. The rookie Jaden Reed deep for the Packers. This is away, but boy, headed straight for the sidelines. The Packers with the football here late in this first half. And with just under a minute to go, they might try to think about mounting a drive here if they can and get in the end zone. Could potentially tie this game up. Love now to pass on 1st down. And this will be caught by his big wide receiver. The Packers going to use one of their timeouts as they get the stoppage with just under 50 seconds remaining in half number one. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. Love from the gun. Toward the center of the field, but it's incomplete. An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. Love looking to throw it. Setting up the screen here, Aaron Jones. And he maybe makes it back to the line of scrimmage. That's it. That helps the completion percentage, but not much else. And now it's third and 10. Now the Packers going to go ahead and use the second of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 33 seconds to go in the first half. They'll line up with four receivers here on third and 10. Throwing, Love. Escaping the pressure. And he can't find a receiver, and he's brought down. The Vikings going to signal for the first of their timeouts. So as they talk it over, we step aside. And here's Daniel Whelan on now to punt. And a fair catch signaled for and taken just outside the 20-yard line. They call that a punt of 38 yards officially. And it will be Vikings ball, first and 10. To start the drive, Hall. Pass caught here by Osborne. He's to the 15. Touchdown, Vikings! KJ Osborne, as the first half is winding down, and the Vikings will extend their lead here just before halftime.
Partner, to me, that touchdown had something that was kind of rooted in that group seeing the future. What I mean by that is, they had a plan. Let's find a way to score right here before the half. And now to give us momentum going into the second half, give us that cushion that we're looking for, they got that accomplished, scoring right before the half ended.
Joseph connects on the extra point, and the lead is now 17-3. So not much time to speak of remaining in this first half as the kick's away. And it's a pretty good return here as he'll get this up to the 29. The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. And with 10 seconds left, not really enough time to put something together. And now a throw on first down there, but it's incomplete.
They tried to make something happen, but that one came up incomplete and really wasn't a good-looking throw.
Yeah, maybe even go as far as to call that a little ill-advised.
Yeah, I would say so. I think that's the right phrase for it. Definitely ill-advised. Just wonder about his mechanics right now, you know, and that's the tough part. You do so much stuff in practice to make it repetitive, but it has to repeat under pressure, whether it's pressure from the defense or just the pressure of playing the game.
So we've reached halftime here on New Year's Eve. As we'll head down to Orlando, that's where we find our man Jonathan Coachman at our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach.
All right, BG, thanks very much. And welcome one and all to our beautiful new downtown Orlando studios for this EA Sports Halftime Report.
All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number three. ...17-3 the score as we resume action for the second half on EA Sports. Keyshawn Nixon now on the return. And he had no room to run as he's tackled down inside the 20. Here's the Packers offense now getting set to start off this third quarter.
Charles, it'll be interesting to see what adjustments this offense made in the locker room. Haven't really been able to get anything going offensively, virtually nothing in the ground attack either. So certainly something has to change here in quarter three.
And I'm pretty sure their friends from the defensive side of the ball told them exactly that, because those guys, the stop troops, they've been playing pretty well and they've kept them around in this game. Now they've got some time. The running game struggled in the first half. Opposition knows how to focus on defending the pass here. They've got to re-energize that ground game and maybe open things up for a comeback here in this half.
Well, they still have time to get them established, but in my estimation, they've got to pick up the urgency here. They've got to get quickly in and out of the huddle and run off a bunch more plays.
From the 20, here's second down and 8. Now they'll toss to Jones running left. Stopped at the 24-yard line after a gain of 5.
I'd say they've got to find a way to get him going. He's such a big part of their offense. I wonder if they might throw it a little and come back to the run.
Anything, because you're right. He's pretty much been completely neutralized.
This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. Love. I had a man open, but missed him, and it's incomplete.
Well, this is just a continuation of what we saw in the first half. So much for the fresh start to begin the third quarter. Still off-target throws, no rhythm throwing the football, and obviously no touchdown scored in this game.
On now is the Packers punter as he's on to kick it away. Here's Powell on the return. So possession goes over here on the punt, and out will come the offense as they take over. It's the Vikings' turn on offense. We get ready for their first possession of the second half. Good starting field position for them as they come up first and 10 at the 39-yard line. Off the play fake. Hall. Flush to his right. And he slides and covers up at the end as he's going to be able to pick up decent yardage. He'll get 5 out of the scramble. It's second down.
I certainly like what he did right there, because he smartly wanted to avoid forcing anything downfield because nothing appeared to be open. Nice harmless slide there to avoid the big hit. And he gets a small gain on the play.
Throwing again on second down. Hall. Into the hands of the rookie Jordan Addison. And they'll work this down to the 40-yard line. Tackled there. He'll get 15 and a Vikings first down.
And now we get into the psychology of the whole thing, because a lot of teams with a two-score lead in the third quarter, they almost become defensive with their offense, just playing not to lose. I think with this team, you got to figure at this point, this is a great spot for them to go into attack mode. Really try and put the hammer down and finish this one off.
Draw play, Madison.
And maybe a little over pursuit there as he's able to take this down to the 25-yard line.
15 yards last play and 15 yards here this go-around.
The defense was dialed into the pass. They overlooked the draw play.
And how often do we talk about the oldies are still goodies? Because that draw play comes straight from Coach Paul Brown's playbook, going all the way back to the original Cleveland Browns.
Now a throw for the left sideline, and he's got it. And he'll go out of bounds in the red zone just inside the 20. It'll be a gain of 5, and it'll be second down. Looking to throw. Hall. He rifles one, and that's going to be intercepted. Picked off by Jair Alexander. And the Packers force the turnover. They'll take over at the 10. Maybe he telegraphed it a little bit right there. You've got a cornerback knowing that he's going against a rookie quarterback. He stepped in and picked it.
You think he had a great week of preparation, looking forward to this opportunity? And the second part of that is, when you're a young quarterback, you are going to stare down targets, but oftentimes your playbook hasn't expanded to give you full field reads as well. Makes it a little bit tougher for him.
Love going to break the huddle, lead the Packers up here first and 10
from back at their own 10-yard line.
And he'll begin the drive with a give to Jones.
And strong running there gets this up over the 15-yard line. It's a 6-yard pickup, and it gets him to 2nd and 4.
From the lineman to the guy running with it, that was a well-executed first down by the offense. With 2 shots left to get the first, you can get a little aggressive here on 2nd down if you want and try for some bigger yardage.
2nd down, another shot for Jones.
And he's taken down, but not before he gets this across the 25-yard line. It's a gain of 12, and the Packers have the first.
I'm okay with the call there. In fact, I actually like it. I know they're down a couple of scores, but the running game worked in that situation. I would continue to go in that direction.
After the run by Jones, here's 1st and 10. Off the play fake, Love.
He'll complete this one to Watson.
And he'll be out of bounds across the 30-yard line. And just 3 yards on the catch there. He couldn't get away. And it's 2nd down.
To throw now. Here's Love. A complete once again to Watson.
And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. Back-to-back receptions for him, and it's another 1st down.
And that's one of the better plays we've seen this offense put together so far. They haven't been able to get on track much at all. But listen, they're only down a couple of scores with the rest of this quarter and the entire 4th remaining, so stranger things have happened.
Couple of 1st downs to kick off the drive. Here's 1st and 10 up at the 46.
Love going to give this one to Jones.
And they'll get this just to the 47. 1 yard gain.
Oh, there's plenty of traffic waiting for him up the middle. But give him credit, he tried barreling through anyway. They're fortunate to get a yard out of that one.
They work now on 2nd and 9. Love now. He short arms that one just a bit. It's low and incomplete.
Well, he'd been targeted quite a bit on this drive, and finally I think the guys on the defensive side, they said no more. They slapped the double coverage on him, made it very tough for him to get the ball.
This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on 3rd down.
Here's Love.
Pressure coming from the Vikings, and they get there and bring him down.
DJ Wadham got off his spot quickly and got to the quarterback.
Pressure can come from all over when you're plotting a defensive strategy. On that particular play, it just came from the outside.
On now is the Packers punter, as he'll punt it away for the fourth time today.
Oh, the return is Powell.
One quarter remains here on a Sunday night. We'll return with more after this break. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. And we return, welcoming you back to Minneapolis. It's the Vikings in possession of the football and the lead. They'll be looking to add to that total as we begin quarter number four. Here are the Vikings now to start their next drive. Now there are two scores on the plus side. Still time here in this fourth quarter, but maybe you start thinking about playing keep away?
Yeah, I think here's the situation. You're not thinking touchdowns anymore.
And that's caught inside the 35. A big play there for Minnesota. 47 yards.
And this is seemingly how it's been all game long. This defense has been just a step too slow. And here they're burned again. Another big play.
So the big play has them all the way down to the 30 now for first and 10. Now a give to Madison. And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. The defense showing some anger after giving up the big play. This time they'll lose one or two.
I think sometimes when you're trying to get after the quarterback, maybe it's better to be lucky than great. Because I think on that one, he's just trying to get upfield and rush the passer. Instead, the tackle for the loss landed right in his lap.
Hall now to throw on second down. He's got a man. It's his tight end. That's complete. And this is going to result in another first down as the tackle's made at the Packers 14. A gain of 18 and a new set of downs.
Partner, I like that they're staying aggressive on offense because to me, this drive is what is known as a put-away drive. You score here, that might put this one to bed. I like the fact that they're playing with confidence and not playing with fear.
Throwing on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete.
He already came through for them on this drive. No surprise that they were hoping he could do it again.
Here's second and 10. Throwing here is Hall. Throw to the right, hauled in by Addison.
And he's got this inside the 10 to the 9 before he's out of bounds. 5 yards, now it's third and 5.
What I love about watching the passing game nowadays is that the one-dimensional receiver is really starting to leave the game. You've got to be able to do it all. Of course, you got to run fast. Of course, you got to catch the ball. But route running savvy and toughness, there's a premium for all of that now.
This will be caught at about the 5. And he's able to get this down to the 5-yard line before he's out of bounds. It'll go as a gain of 4. And that's going to bring up a fourth down.
So much about offense is what you call hidden yardage. You know, you throw the ball to someone, they catch it, and then they can make a big play. You know, they create a play, run after catch. They did a really nice job of limiting that and keeping him from a first down.
Yeah, stopped him in his tracks. So give him the first down, first and goal after a pickup of 4, and the decision to go for it pays off. Starting to look like this drive, it may be the final nail in the coffin.
Well, this is why you work out so hard, right? This is why you spend all that time in the offseason. This is why you have those OTAs and mini camps for these situations, these scenarios, to run someone into the ground and secure a victory.
Now a throw to the end zone on first down, but it winds up incomplete.
That was a touchdown if he could have hung on. Instead, it was a well-timed collision to jar that one free.
An incomplete pass on first down. Here's second and goal.
Madison diving for the end zone, and he is in. Touchdown.
Sometimes offenses can get too cute down near the goal line, but there's nothing fancy about this one. As Coach Lombardi would say, we get a seal here, and we get a seal here, and we run this play in the alley. And that's good work to hit the hole hard and finish in the end zone.
Joseph connects on the extra point.
And the lead now to 3 touchdowns at 21.
Now Joseph tees it up to kick off following the touchdown. Nixon now from his end zone.
And that decision to bring it out ends up not being a good one. Costs him about 5 yards as he's tackled at the 20. The Packers offense now, they get ready to head back onto the field.
See if they can put this drive in the end zone, Charles, because it's been a little bit of a rough go at times. They've had to punt the football a ton in this ball game because of stalled out drives.
So are you saying that you're kind of tired of seeing the punter run out there and do his thing during this game? Is that what you're trying to say?
I'm okay with it. I have a feeling that this offense, they don't want to see the punter again.
And frankly, the punter doesn't want to run out there anymore himself. He would love to see his offense put together a drive and give his leg a rest.
And the offense moving quickly to the line. Play action this time with Love.
Now this thrown deep for Kraft.
And that's caught inside the 30. It's a big play there for Green Bay. 53 yards.
And normally when you think about huge field flipping plays like this, it's that shifty slot receiver, that burner on the outside. Not here. That's a tight end doing work down the field. Where's the oxygen mask? He's going to need it after that one. A big, big play.
And it's a Packers touchdown.
Romeo Doubs
from 17 yards out.
And the Packers are finally into the end zone here in this fourth quarter. Well, they needed 3 scores to have any chance. There's the first of the 3 as they get into the end zone.
Yeah, Brandon, I think that our guys at Next Gen Stats in charge of the win probability are probably saying your chances still aren't great. But now, you still got more than 3 minutes to go. You got to focus on the task at hand, which is going to be getting the football back as quickly as possible.
Carlson's extra point up and good.
And that cuts the lead to 24-10. Two scores down, 3 timeouts left. Still a chance if they can somehow get this one back. And the Vikings able to recover. The hands team does its job. And that's why you have your hands team out there on the field. Those are the best guys ready to make that play.
And let's face it, it was executed well. It wasn't a bad kick. It wasn't anything like that, just that the normal outcome actually came to play. Analytics would tell you it's a very low possibility of getting the ball for the team kicking it in an onside kick situation.
You're all about the numbers, aren't
you? All about the numbers, baby. It's a new game now.
They don't lie. Running from the shotgun with Madison. And they will stop him after a fairly minimal pickup. Kenny Clark, the big D tackle there to make the stop. And when do they start thinking about burning these timeouts? They've got all 3 still defensively.
To me, you have to start right now. Here's the time, and that means you've got to stop them on defense, not give up the yardage, use your timeouts in order to get the ball back and try and score yourself. But now is the time to start using those timeouts.
And keep in mind, it'll also stop the clock at the 2-minute warning.
They'll fake it on the jet sweep, and instead a handoff up the middle.
Call it a gain of 5 that time, and they'll be left with a 3rd and about 4.
Brandon, I've got to think this offensive line has got some smiles on its faces. And I know it sounds crazy,
But they practiced for this back in training camp. They knew they'd be in situations where it'd be extra defenders in the box coming after them, trying to keep them from locking down a game. Right now, they want to show the world they're up to the challenge.
So the Vikings in possession of the football as we get you reset. They've got a third down now as they look for one more first down to help salt this one away. And the Packers give him nowhere to go, and they bring him down. And now right out of the two-minute break, we'll get a timeout used defensively with a minute 56 to go. Now here's Ryan right now as he'll punt it away for the second time. And this is going to be ruled out, I think, just inside the 20. Yes, it will. Side judge calls it at the 19-yard line. So here's Love and the Packers down by two touchdowns. A minute 52 to play. It's been a struggle to score all day, and now they need to do it twice here late to have a chance. Love looking to throw it. Short throw, he's got Kraft. And able to get this across the 20 before going out of bounds. At this stage, this drive's got to be touchdown or bust because you need two of them.
And if I'm the offensive play caller, I'm not just looking at my dagger plays downfield. I'm looking at some of my specials, something that can fool them and give you a big play now.
With a sense of urgency.
No doubt.
Love to Dobbs, and he hauls it in. Two timeouts still remaining, but scoring quickly, a must. It's first and 10. Throwing there, but this pass is going to wind up incomplete.
Give it big credit for his coverage right there, because when he saw the route break deep, he stayed in position to prevent a completion while avoiding any risk of a flag.
They'll try again here, second and 10. Here's Love. He's going to let it fly. That's going to be knocked away and incomplete.
That was one they needed to connect on. They're down, but not quite out. So you have to figure, with under 2 minutes to play, they need to hit on something in very short order.
The sound reverberating here in the dome. This is third down. Now Love. Watson making the catch. Down the left sideline. And he's going to get it down to the 14-yard line.
Well, defensively there, you want to play it a little safe and keep the action in front of you. But you definitely aren't looking to give up plays like that. They still got the cushion of a two-score lead, but don't give them a freebie here in the final minute.
Here's first and 10. To pass, here's Jordan Love. Looking middle, and it's incomplete.
A lot of practice time, a lot of thinking goes into two-minute drills, even on the defensive side. So now you want to make sure the guys understand. Continue to be aggressive, but make sure you're smart in doing so.
Another try from the 14 on second and 10. Again, it's Love. Toward the end zone, but that's going to wind up incomplete.
So many times when we talk about coverage, we're just about a defender running with a receiver, but a big part of it is understanding where the football is, finding it. In this case, when it arrived, it wasn't a surprise, and he was able to bat it away.
Well, this crowd is making an impact right now. Third and 10. Now Love. And this is caught for a touchdown. So hang on now. Things just got a little bit more interesting here in the final minute. Okay, game on. Don't go anywhere yet. You got a one-score game now. Probably going to rely on the onside kick coming up.
Yeah, they have to. It's not a high percentage play, but it's better than not having a chance at all. And that's when you put your leapers and your flyers on one side, get that high hop, and hope that one of the guys can come up with it.
And on the other side, get that hands team ready.
No doubt about it.
Carlson's extra point up and good.
And now things get a bit more interesting here in this fourth quarter. So still a chance with just over 20 seconds to go, but they need to get this one back, no doubt. And this is going to be recovered by the hands team. And that should just about put a capper on this one. The risk reward of the onside kick, when you don't get it, the risk comes out to play, and here they gave up great field position.
And that's the key to everything, because you're trying your best to press advantages when you have them. And field position leads you to that type of play calling, and whether you want to blitz or whether you want to throw the ball deep, those types of things, now that they've given up that type of field position, the advantage has switched to their opponent.
Still with a couple of timeouts. We'll see if they want to use them. Now the Packers going to go ahead and use the second of their timeouts as the clock will stop with an even 20 seconds left to go. Victory formation time for the Vikings as they'll take a knee here. Now the Packers going to burn their third and final timeout. And as the two teams talk it over on their respective sidelines, we take a break. Down to a knee one more time, and that should just about do it. What a ball game this was. What an atmosphere this was, and the home team getting the late touchdown, getting the victory, and now everybody in this building can file away with smiles on their faces.
And what do real estate people tell us all the time? It's location, location, location. So being at home, that can be a big deal, because remember, they were down to their final chance to retake the lead. That home field advantage, I think it helped fuel all of what happened for them down the stretch. A huge win.
So that'll do it for us. For my partner, Charles Davis, and all the hard-working men and women on our crew, I'm Brandon Gaughton. You've been watching the NFL.